There is a recruitment drive. NALCO have started a recruitment drive for B.Sc chemistry students only. The name of the post is SUPT JOT Laboratory. That post is specifically for B.Sc chemistry candidates. Naturally, the syllabus will be B.Sc chemistry honors. But I selected few important topics. These important topics are must for NALCO examination. Why? I selected this topic using the profile of NALCO. What is NALCO doing? What is the job profile of NALCO? Actually, what business NALCO have? So for a preparation, you must at least learn these topics. You have to prepare complete B.Sc chemistry syllabus, but among the B.Sc chemistry, but you must prepare these few important topics. So let's discuss what are the important topics for B.Sc chemistry students, that is SUPT JOT Laboratory. First of all, we will start with inorganic chemistry portions. Inorganic chemistry, the most and very most of our topic is metallurgy. NALCO, National Aluminium Company, is basically dealing with alloy related materials. Okay, they are actually refining the different kinds of alloy, mostly bauxite. They are preparing carbon steel. They are preparing different materials using alloy. So the important topic of metallurgy is you must learn ore, minerals, bauxite. Okay. Process of metal refining, bare process. Bare is basically a process in metallurgy. Metallurgy of iron, steel and alloy. Okay, these are the few important topics for metallurgy portion. Next is chemical bonding. So in chemical bonding, you have to learn about VSEPR theory, molecular orbital, hybridization. Regarding this, a video is available in your YouTube channel, Shayan Shastrii. I made a small short regarding the determination of the structure of a molecule. That will be available in the description link. Okay, so you can watch that video for learning of chemical bonding. Next is industrially inorganic chemistry. So here you have to learn about the preparation of mineral acids, composition of alloy, preparation of sodium hydroxide, sulfuric acid, HCl. These are the important topics. Main group chemistry. In main group chemistry, you have to mostly understand or read about the S block, P block elements. For example, in S block elements, we have a 2 blocks. In P block, we have a 6 blocks. You mostly read about the preparation of these compounds. Okay. For example, what are the industrially important compounds using the P block elements? That is carbon family or nitrogen family. Must read about this kind of things. Coordination chemistry. Yes, you should learn about Werner's theory, VBT, MO, CFT, hybridization of various compounds. Basics first. Atomic structure, calculation of energy, quantum. You must learn about the quantum numbers. Because organization is continuously asking the questions regarding the quantum numbers. This video is also available in your YouTube channel, Akshan Shastrii. You can watch that video and learn about the quantum numbers. Now next is periodic variation. There are different kind of properties, for example, electronegativity, ionization energy, electron gain enthalpy. What are the variations of these properties along the group and along the period? You must learn about the terms of physical chemistry. In chemical kinetics, you have to learn about the graphs of different kind of chemical reactions. Rate of the chemical reaction, Arrhenius theory, there's a temperature dependence of chemical reaction, and calculation of order, first order, second order, zero weight order. This is also available in the channel. Equilibrium. Here you learn about phase diagrams, mostly sulfur water phase diagram. Don't go for organic compound phase diagram, but sulfur, the phase diagram of sulfur is most important. Then acid base, calculation of Kp, Kc, Ks, their solubility product. Why this acid base? Acid base is very important. Okay. For example, calculation of the molarity, molality, calculation of your normality. These are the important things for acid base portion. Thermodynamics. Learn about free energy calculations. There is a Gibbs free energy, Helmholtz free energy. Okay. What are the possibilities of spontaneity of the reactions? What are the criteria of spontaneity of the reaction? Learn about that. Carnot engine is very important. Then basic equation. Basic equation stands for basically first order, second order, zero weight order. Okay, learn about this kind of things. So physical chemistry next portion is polymers. So in polymers, we have to learn about the different type of method for the calculation of molecular weight. This portion is very important because in industry, polymer is one of the most important compound. Next is solid state. In solid state, we have to learn about the type of alloys. Okay, what are the voids? Okay. What is the calculation of coordination numbers and its examples? You don't have to learn about the radius ratio rules, okay guys, but you must learn about the coordination numbers. For example, the coordination of the sodium solid is basically 6 by 6, so this kind of thing. Next is electrochemistry. In electrochemistry, Nernst equation is the most important part. Then we have to do the conductivity calculations. For example, that equation R equal to rho L by A, very important very important portion. Okay, syllabus is B.Sc honors chemistry, but I am actually talking about the few important topics that you should not ignore. Now here comes my organic chemistry. The very first important thing is GOC, general organic chemistry. Here you have to learn about the acid base, organic chemistry acid base, as well as inorganic chemistry acid base. These two are the important topics. In organic chemistry acid base, you have to learn about the various kind of organic acids and what is its variations and what are the organic bases, what is its variations. Okay, well, next is carbocation stability. Whenever you are learning about the carbocation stability, always go through the reactions which leads to the formation of carbocations. For example, rearrangement reaction, elimination reaction, ROH to alkene, alkene to ROH, this kind of things. Hydrocarbon. In hydrocarbon, yes, we have to learn about the complete B.Sc chemistry, but must focus on industrial preparation of alkanes, alkenes and alkynes. Okay, that is basically I'm talking about the Kolbe's reaction. Carbonyl compounds are mostly learn about or study about the name reaction associated with carbonyl compound. I accumulated some miscellaneous topics. This is very important. First is environmental chemistry in any industry, whether it is a carbon steel industry, whether it is an alloy industry, whether it is an oil and gas industry, textile industry, there is some waste product. And there are few important quality parameters that must comply. Okay, so one is this BOD. BOD stands for biological oxygen demand. Must learn about that. COD, chemical oxygen demand. Effluent treatment plant. Okay, for example, in alloy industries, what are the waste product that it generates? What is its environmental concern? Learn about that. Industrially important compound. This is very important. For example, borane. Okay, this kind of things. Learn about these things. You must learn about the qualitative analysis of acid-base radicals. Basically, I'm talking about the group theory. Group theory means we have a group 0, 1, 2, 3, 3A, 3B, like this. Okay, this kind of topic is very important. And again, you must learn about the some topics related with your organic chemistry practical. For example, a scientist. Okay, so friend, these are the some important topics regarding the NALCO SUPT JOT laboratory post. Go through the complete syllabus, that is B.Sc honors syllabus, but must focus on these important topics. So friends, stay tuned to Shastrii YouTube channel for more such latest updates. Thank you.